Okay, so we're going to talk about adding and subtracting fractions. So adding and subtracting fractions are a big deal. I mean, you deal with fractions so much in math that you absolutely need to know how to work with fractions. And I know that for the most part, fractions do not tend to be our friend. Most people absolutely hate working with fractions. So hopefully we can make this a little bit less painless than it has to be. So when it comes to adding and subtracting fractions, so we have four general steps when it does come to doing that. Okay, so our first step is to find the lowest common denominator. Because for the most part, you're going to be given an example where you do not have common denominators. And in order to add and subtract fractions, you have to have common denominators. There's no way around that. They have to be the same denominators. So of course your teachers are working, you know, problems in algebra and stuff like that. They're not going to give you the easy examples that have common denominators already. You're going to get the other examples where they're not the same. You need to work on finding those common denominators first. And after you're done doing that, then your next step is to convert your fractions. Because then you need to take the fractions that you have and convert them to have common denominators. And then when you're done with that, then you can finally add or subtract the fractions depending on which calculation you're doing. And then always in the end, doesn't matter what calculation you're doing with fractions, whether you're adding, subtracting, multiplying, dividing, you must always, always, always simplify your fraction in the end. All right, so those are our four general steps. So before actually going into examples where we're actually adding and subtracting fractions, I want to very briefly go over a couple of examples on how to convert fractions. So once we find our common denominator, what do? How do we change our fractions to have that common denominator? So let's take a look at this example over here, the 2/5. Let's say we had the fraction 2/5, right? But our common denominator was 35. So we need to take 2/5 and we need to switch that over to make it look like something over 35, right? So what we would need to do here, so the process that you need to be thinking is, well, you specifically first need to be looking at your denominators. We're concerned with getting common denominators, and that's what we need to be focused on. Okay, so for this fraction that we have a denominator of a 5. Now we need to convert it, we need to change it to have a denominator of a 35. So our process is, we have a 5, okay, well I need to change it to a 35. So then, 5 times what is going to give me a 35? And that's what we need to think of. 5 times what is going to give me a 35, right? So 5 times 2 times 5 times 5, 5 times what? So hopefully we do know our times tables, and we do know that 5 times a 7 is 35. So what we do is we multiply the numerator and the denominator by 7. We can't just multiply the denominator, we need to multiply both. And I want you to ignore everything else for right now and just take a look at this fraction here. Really, when I'm multiplying by the 7/7, can you tell me what 7/7 actually equals? What is 7/7? All right, so if I have 7 divided by 7, which is what this really is, now 7 divided by 7 is just a 1, right? And if I multiply something by 1, it's not going to change its value, right? 5 times 1 is still a 5. Negative 2 times 1 is still a negative 2. It doesn't change its value. What it does is it changes what it looks like, and that's what we want. We don't want to change the value of this fraction. We just want to change what it looks like to make it suit our needs so that we can add these fractions together. So what we do is we multiply by the numerator and the denominator, that number that would get this denominator to equal this denominator, right? So since the 7's going to work here, I'm going to multiply both top and bottom by that 7. And when we multiply fractions, we go straight across. 2 times 7 is 14, and 5 times 7 is going to get me that 35. So this would be my converted fraction. So taking a look at our next example over here, we have a 1/7. We want to convert this one to have a denominator of a 49, right? So what we need to do is think, okay, well 7 times what is a 49, right? So 7 times 7 happens to be a 49. Now, that's just a coincidence. That I mean for those to be exactly the same, right? But 7 times 7 is a 49. So here I'm going to multiply by 7 over 7 and multiply that across. 1 times 7 is a 7. 7 times 7 is this 49. So that, once again, would be my converted fraction. Over here, right? I have 2 nines. I want to convert this to have a denominator of 99. So I need to look at the 9 and think 9 times what is a 99? Well, 9 times 11 happens to be 99. So I need to multiply numerator and denominator by 99. Multiplying that across, 2 times 11, I'll get 22 over this 99. Okay, so this process we do a lot. We do a ton of it when it comes to adding and subtracting fractions because we pretty much all the time have to convert our fractions and we need to know how to do this process here. So let's go ahead and work on actually adding and subtracting some fractions together. So our first example, let's start somewhat simple. Here we have 1/3 plus 1/5. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and add these fractions together. Now, do note, right, always do take a look just to make sure you weren't lucky, you weren't given one of those examples, or hey, I do have a common denominator, we can go ahead and add them together. Like I said, very rarely are you going to get this. A 3 is not the same thing as a 5. We do not have common denominators, so we need to work on that. So, as far as finding a common denominator, there's a few different thought processes that you can use. Some people just like to multiply the numbers together, and that will always work. It may not always be the lowest common denominator, but it will be a common denominator. So you can always just multiply your two denominators together, and that will give you a common denominator. 3 times 5 is 15, so I can use 15 as my common denominator. Another process that you can do is just write down your denominators. So my denominators are a 3 and a 5. And actually list all your multiples. So when I say multiples, I mean times tables. 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21, 24, and so on. Right? 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, and so on. And what you're doing is you're looking for the first number that they have in common. Right, so when I'm comparing these two, the first number I have in common is a 15. A third process that some people sometimes use is they check to see, does the smaller one go into the bigger one? Does 3 go into 5? No. So run your multiples of 5. Okay, so after 5 I have 10. Does 3 go into that? No. Next is 15. Does 3 go into that? Yes. So you know 15 would work. So there's a few different processes you can go through to find the lowest common denominator. All right, so ours is going to be 15. So then the next thing that we would need to do, we found the common denominator, it's a 15, convert the fractions. So somewhere off to the side, right, you want to write your fractions down, right, so that you can convert them. Here I have a 1/3, I also have 1/5. I need to convert both of them because neither one of them has the denominator of a 15. So then I'm going to look at the 1/3, right? It needs to be converted to a denominator of 15. So 3 times what is a 15? Well, 3 times a 5 will get me that. So I'm going to multiply by 5 over 5. Multiplying that across, 1 times 5 is 5. 3 times 5 is 15. So this fraction, so 1/3 is 5 over 15. Same thing for the 1/5. Here I have a 5. I want to convert it to a 15. So 5 times a 3 would be a 15. So here I'm going to multiply by 3 over 3. Multiplying that across, 1 times 3 is a 3. 5 times 3 is that 15. So this fraction is 3/15. I'm going to drop down the plus sign here in between them. So instead of adding 1/3 plus 1/5, I'm adding 5/15 plus 3/15. These are my converted fractions. And remember, you can only add or subtract.